Good morning, good morning. It's morning here where you are. It might be coming up on afternoon. Welcome, welcome. Welcome to Raincross Farms Makery. If you're new, I am Robin, and behind the camera, behind the computer is my husband, Bill, and we are located just outside of Lewiston, Idaho. And honestly, if I get distracted, if I kind of start staring off into space, it's because we are having the most beautiful snowfall straight out my window. So I'm kind of mesmerized by it. Honestly, we both grew up in Southern California, so any snow we got, we had to travel to. And so I don't know about you, but I rarely saw it coming down. So this is just a real treat for us. We've only lived up here about 3 years. And anyway, that's what's going on. So let me see if I can pull up. So when you're here, hop on, say hello. Hi, Liana. Hi, Patty. Welcome. Of course, y'all know what to do. Love our page. Follow our page. I'd love to get some new followers today. Welcome if you are watching from Craft Round the Clock. We are so thrilled to be invited to be shared onto your page. And also, if you're so inclined, please sprinkle our video so other people can enjoy the crafty goodness. Okay.
Okay. She said morning, and
I don't know why you got a message because you typed morning. I don't think that's one of my keywords. Anyway, enjoy whatever message it was.
Alana, are you feeling better today?
Welcome, Alana. Welcome, Beverly. Welcome, Marquita. Shauna, welcome. Shauna, I saw you on another post. You are like, what? Negative 44?
That's true.
How are you able to breathe? Well, welcome from Canada. Okay, awesome. Linda Jo, welcome. Lisa, thank you for raining on the farm. Sherry K, Jenna, welcome. Awesome. Love having new visitors. Yes, we got very little rain on the farm this summer, so all this snowpack is exciting. Anyway, okay, you're in the house and crafting. Well, yeah, I hope you got a really good heater. Sissa, welcome. Okay, so a little bit of background, full disclosure. I am an independent designer for Chalk Couture, but if we do any chalking, it's going to be at the very end because I wanted to show you how to make your own lip balm. I discovered doing this maybe 4 or 5 years ago, and I don't buy the stuff from the store. So it's super easy. It's just getting the right supplies and seeing the technique, and let me show you how. So let's get started. I'm going to read some comments. Charmaine, welcome. First time watcher. Feel free to follow our page. If you're watching from a phone, those of you that are new, if you're watching from a phone, if you click on the top, like poke me in the forehead on your phone, and it should pop up Raincross Farms Makery, and then there should be three dots at the top. If you click on those three dots, it gives you a bunch of options, and one of them is to follow our page, one of them is to turn on text notifications, one of them is to favorite our page. So while you're watching, you could take care of business, so go for it. Okay. April, welcome. Sherry, welcome.
Indiana, you know what? We're still looking for people from,
I don't know, it's
South Dakota, it's North Dakota,
and Alaska, and
Alaska,
Hawaii. Okay.
And okay, Washington, so, D.C.
Okay, TikTok, we're on a clock because of Craft Around the Clock. I got somebody following me up in about 40 minutes, so let's get to lip balming. Okay, so where to begin? Okay, let me just show you this. This is the kit that I bought off of Amazon. And this isn't the ingredients, but this is the packaging. So this kit allows you to create the tubes. Okay? So what it comes with is instructions, and you get this little grid thing and this scraper tool. And I'll show you in a minute how you take, you also get the tubes, and I'll show you how using this, you're able to fill 50 tubes of lip balm in no time. Okay, instead of trying to pour it in one tube at a time, which would take forever. Okay, so this like streamlines that. And they also give you some stickers. Some of mine don't have stickers on them, but you can kind of see these are stickers my husband actually printed up, but these are the exact same things, and they actually give you the template for printing them yourself. You could decorate them by hand if you wanted to, but they also give you the template, either a QR code or the numbers you can punch into Microsoft Word if you want to do your own labels. So you can design your own labels, which is great for gifting or for selling. I have done both. Okay. Another option for packaging, if you don't like the tubes, is you can get these little mini containers. I don't even know what they're called. They're like little beauty containers, and it has a screw top lid, and this actually holds a little bit more than the tube does if you measured it out. So this is another option. They're just a little more tedious to fill. You have to fill them one at a time, not like you can do with this. Okay, so we'll try to do some of both of them. Well, let's get started with the ingredients. Let me set this aside because we'll have time to mess with this. Okay, so what you need for this recipe is peppermint cocoa lip balm. It smells, well, you don't really taste it, you don't really lick it, but it smells like chocolate and peppermint. So probably the key ingredient is the beeswax. And I get their beeswax pellets or pastilles. And I either get the white, or I make sure I get really light pale yellow. They also have some really bright yellow stuff, which might not be too aesthetically pleasing in your lip balm, but beeswax. And if you're interested, I have Amazon links to all of these products. What do I have you type in? Lip balm. If you type in lip balm in the comments, my bot will send you a link, and it will have all of the products. We are, full disclosure, we are Amazon affiliates. So if you purchase something using one of our links, we get a small commission. But anyway, some of these things are sold in craft stores, which is fine. I haven't bought any in craft stores. I've only bought it online, so I don't know the price differences. But anyway, I'm telling you how to get it on Amazon, but you can look for the same things in craft stores. Okay, I've talked to Myla a minute. Have I missed anything? Hi, Wilma from Happy Arts in Crafts, Oregon. Awesome. And you're commenting. I can't see all the comments.
I was asking her what part of Oregon, because we're in Lewiston, Idaho. We're almost neighbors.
Yeah, depends on what part of Oregon.
We were just over in Enterprise for our Daisy dog getting surgery, and we were headed back and got called back because the winds and the snow and everything was so bad.
Hopefully you haven't had horrible weather in Oregon. Okay, so beeswax, pellets. Pellets will help it melt easier. And then this is cocoa butter. It's kind of all wrapped up in here. I'll show you in a moment. But this is raw, pure cocoa butter. This is what gives it that chocolatey scent. And then coconut oil. You don't have to use the big old thing from Costco. That's just what I have. So these are the three main ingredients. We're also going to add in some vitamin E oil, because that's good for your lips. Some vitamin E oil and some peppermint, essential oils. So that'll give it the peppermint scent. And then if you want to color it, you can just use lipstick. And I got this at the Dollar Tree. Find a color that you like. I have never colored my lip balm before. I've always just used it, the kind of the clear clear color, but we're going to try coloring it with some Dollar Tree, bright red, Hoochie Mama lipstick. Okay, feel free to interrupt me if we get some good comments that I need to. Okay, let's see. Welcome, let me just back up and welcome some people. April, welcome from New York. Tracy, Valerie, Linda Joe, April, Sherry, Cindy, Wilma, Debbie, welcome Debbie. Okay, well, anyway, welcome everybody. So again, we're making lip balm, beeswax, cocoa butter, coconut oil, and then optional vitamin E oil and peppermint essential oils. You could swap this out for a different scent also. Okay, so we're going to use these three for the tubes. We're going to use these three in equal amounts. So 1 to 1 to 1. And then we're going to melt it. So let me set these aside. And you need to know how much. So basically, if I were to fill, here's math. Just bear with me and gloss over it. These are 0.15 ounces. So if you multiply that by 50, because you can do 50 at a shot, that is 7.5 ounces. So you just take whatever your final total needs to be, and you divide it by 3, and that's how much of each thing you measure out. So I'm going to measure out about 2.5 ounces of each of these. So if you were filling 1 ounce jars and you were filling 5 of them, you would want a total of 5 ounces. You divide that by 3, and that's how much you would use. Okay, so I'm going to turn on my little postal scale, and I'm going to weigh out my beeswax. None of your beeswax. Okay.
So April said it's in there, we can put what we use to make and to keep up with everything. That would be if they were to type in.
If you type in lip balm, you'll get the list of the Amazon links to the supplies that I used. I can come up with a complete supply list, but that would probably be your best thing. And you're welcome to watch the replay. Okay, so beeswax, again, I'm gonna do a third of my total. So I'm gonna do 2.5 ounces. And stand up so I can read it. And whoop, almost there. There we go, 2.5 ounces. Okay, I don't know if you need to see it from the overhead. My cameraman is busy texting. So 2.5 ounces. And to melt this, you can do it two ways. I'm going to do it in the microwave. You can also do it in a double boiler. But don't do it directly over the heat, because you'll end up scorching your stuff. Okay, so I've got 2.5 ounces of beeswax. Now I'm going to do 2.5 ounces of 2.5 ounces of coconut oil. And this is pretty solid in there, so I'm going to kind of scrape it out. And this is the coconut oil that is solid at room temperature. If you use the kind that's liquid, it'll still work, but your lip balm will be much softer. It might not do too well in a tube. And if you type in lip balm and you don't have enough information, just feel free to message me, message the page, and I'd be glad to give you more information. Okay. Probably should have pre-measured this. Okay, I'm at 1 ounce. Doesn't help that it's cold down here. We are down in our basement. We came down early and turned on the heaters to kind of warm it up.
The dogs are happy.
Yeah, because they're with us. Okay, getting to two and a half.
Getting my phone blown up. I can't even watch because I keep getting messages.
Well, because you're popular.
That's what it is.
Okay. Again, 2.5 ounces of coconut oil. And I'm going to dump that in there. Now, I'm going to get this melting first. That beeswax is going to take a while to melt. It seems like you'll microwave it and over and over and over, and it's like it's not melting, and eventually it will.
Okay, so just while you're doing that, how many ounces of that did you do?
Okay, I did 2.5 ounces of each because I wanted my total to be 7.5 ounces. So I divided that by 3, and I used that much of each of these ingredients. Okay, so I'm just going to set that for a couple of minutes. Again, you can use a double boiler. And then I'm going to do my cocoa butter. Now, cocoa butter is kind of delicate, so I'm going to add this in after that's melted so it doesn't scorch. It melts pretty quickly. So this is what my cocoa butter looks like. It's kind of melted and reconstituted itself. But I'm going to pull out 2.5 ounces of it. Oh, smells yummy.
Really bright today, and I'm not sure why.
So did that make sense? Okay, what are the three? I'm using beeswax pellets and coconut oil and cocoa butter. There we go. 2.5 ounces of that. I'm going to put this leftover back in the bag. You can swap out some different... You can swap out some different oils, but you need to be careful because it will affect your consistency. Let me get this cleaned up. And while that's melting,
I'm writing it in the comments.
Okay.
Beeswax pellets, cocoa butter, and what's the third one?
Coconut oil.
Coconut oil. That's right. I just wanted to make sure.
And it's 1:1:1. And I'm going to check on this. Now, don't let this go for a long amount of time. Keep checking it every minute or so. So you can kind of see the coconut oil is melting, but the beeswax pellets are still holding their shape. I don't know if you can see that. So it's not quite ready. So just give it a stir and then put it back in for another minute. You don't want to overheat it, because then it'll burn. Okay, so I'm going to put that in for another minute, and I'm going to set up. What did I do? And I'm going to set up my tubes. So here is my tray, and I'm going to turn it upside down, and you will get the caps and the tubes. And all you do is shove them in there. Makes it super, super easy to fill these.
So you're putting the opening
down. I'm putting the opening down.
Fill from the other side.
Mm-hmm. And then I'm going to fill it from the top. Now, if I didn't want to fill all of these, if I just wanted to make 10, that's fine. You would just tape off the open holes that you're not going to use. And again, you don't have to use these tubes, but they just look very professional. And I'm going to stop and stir. Okay, so it's melting even more, but still, oh, you can't see it. Still, those beeswax are still holding their shape. One of these days, we may have our own beeswax to use for this. We have bees. We're still working on getting some honey. This is just their first year. Okay, so I'm going to go back to filling these. Any questions? And again, I have some links to where you can buy these from Amazon. If you comment lip balm, you'll get that notification. But they also sell these. They also sell these ingredients in craft stores. I know I've seen them at Michael's, and I know I've seen it at Hobby Lobby. I can't vouch for the price of them, though. You might find them over where they have soaps and candles. That might be where they have them. And they may even have some starter kits with the ingredients. Not sure. These punched in. How am I doing on time? So far, so good. Doop, 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 doop. Filling my lip balm tubes.
So Alana wants to know, are you trying to completely liquefy the ingredients?
Yes.
Or just get them to a soft pouring
stage? They need to be liquefied because I need to meld them all together. So it needs to all be liquid. Okay, so I've got all 50 of them there. So I'm pushing down to make sure they're all attached. And you can see on the top, they're all just it just lines up right there.
Now, just because of my brain, do they come automatically with that little screw thing all the way at the bottom?
They do. And you can kind of check, but I have never found one that didn't have it all the way screwed down.
Otherwise, it won't pull up all the way, right?
Right. So, still that beeswax is hanging on, but it's starting to melt. You see that? Now, another caution is, you're working with wax, so when you go to clean up, don't pour this down your drain. You don't want wax stuck in on your pipes. And I'm going to get out a few of these. Get out just a few of these. We'll fill up some of these. Now, one thing about the tubs is you might want it to be a little, not quite as stiff. So you might want to add just a touch more coconut oil if you want it to be a little bit looser, because you're pulling it out with your finger and you want it a little stiffer in the tube. So when it comes up, it stays. Okay, so now we wait until it melts. Okay. And one thing I did not put on the Amazon list is peppermint oil, because you can get that at drugstores. You can get it at grocery stores. Some of you may already have a supplier of essential oils, so you can use that. And then vitamin E oil, you can use the capsules, or you can use just the liquid. And that you can get at a drugstore. See, now it's starting to melt. That beeswax is just about completely melted. So now I'm going to add in my cocoa butter, because again, I don't want to overheat the cocoa butter. The others, they can take a little more heat. So I'm adding in cocoa butter, and I'm going to put that in there. I don't want to get wax all over. And I'm going to heat it again for another minute. So I don't know, how many times has that been?
I keep in count.
Maybe 6 minutes or so? Yes, that would be bad. And again, you can use a double broiler if you don't want to use a microwave. I've just found a microwave works a whole lot easier, less cleanup. But again, don't overheat it because you can scorch your oil. Okay. So am I still mesmerizing you? Okay, lip balm supplies. Okay. If you type in lip balm and my bot does not send you a message, I will send it. I will go back through all the comments and I'll make sure you get it. Because I see Nancy typed in lip balm supplies and
it showed up down lower.
Oh, did it?
Alana.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Alana interrupted again.
Oh goodness, Alana.
What are we gonna do with that?
Alana, we're gonna keep loving her. Okay, that's getting a little warm. So now I'm melting that cocoa butter, and it's starting to smell like chocolate because cocoa butter. Now it looks a little yellow. That will lighten up as it dries. It won't be that stark yellow. It'll lighten up. And you can get pure white beeswax pellets. This was just what was available. And they're kind of a creamy color. But when it solidifies, it lightens up. On time.
Patty, we know that feeling. She says she's at the grocery store and I'll have to watch the replay. Walking through Walmart.
Please do. Please do.
Turn on stuff.
And all of you, we love you letting us know you're here watching. And if it says the red box says live, you're watching us live. If you're watching us and that red box isn't up there, you're watching the replay, and we welcome. And please comment hashtag replay so we know you were here. That's for future, if you're here now. Okay. And those of you, we've discovered one thing. My bot does not send, does not work with YouTube. So we are going to upload this video to YouTube, and so YouTube watchers, look for the link to the product link. Look for that in the description. Once we get that posted, we will put that link in the description. Okay, so I've almost got that. If I had,
Jessica says hi, and Tina Maskew, Little Miss.
Hey, Tina. Hello, hi. Tina. Welcome.
That's interesting.
My, I don't know. What is our relationship, Tina?
We're friends.
We are like mother-in-laws together. Almost.
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 Which reminds me, Tina, you and I need to have a chat. So okay. One of these days when I have some free time, I'm going to give you a call. You can call me either way.
Okay, so I'm thinking one more minute should do it. I had that big chunk of cocoa butter. If you chop it up even smaller, it melts faster, of course. Okay, almost to the good part. Now, when I pour this in, it's gonna need a couple hours to set up, which is not a big deal. So, but you won't be able to see the finished product, but you'll see the process. And here's the finished product. What I like about these stickers is they have a little tab, and it is perforated, so it looks very professional. I don't know if you can show it. See that little tab that extends over the cap? So whoever is receiving it or purchasing it will know nobody has used it on their lips because it's kind of safety sealed. Those are the old ones. And that is one thing. I made these probably 3 years ago. And they are still just as fresh as ever. They're not stale. They're not rancid. They hold really well. Okay, so I've got this completely melted. And you might want to switch to overhead. Okay. You might want to switch to overhead. He's not listening. And he can't blame his hearing aids. Okay, so vitamin E oil. You can use the capsules. You would probably do like 3 or 4 of them for this amount. And or you can just use the oil, the liquid oil. And I'm going to put in 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, maybe 10 drops. Okay. Vitamin E, good for your lips. And then peppermint oil, I'm probably going to put like maybe 20 drops in here. I don't know. No, I'm not counting. I'm just dropping it in. Okay. You go with your nose. Don't taste it. Go with your nose. If it smells pepperminty enough, it'll be good. Okay. So I got all that mixed in. Now I'm going to use some. And again, I haven't done this before. This is Dollar Tree lipstick. And I'm going to shave some of it in there and kind of give our lip balm some color. So hopefully it doesn't just turn orange. Ooh, pretty, pretty. It is orange, but let's add a little more.
All you're using the lipstick for is just
coloring. Just for coloring. And I doubt we're adding enough to where it would color your lips. I think it will just color the lip balm. So, pretty color. Okay, so that's all mixed in. I'm going to set this aside. Now remember, I'll show you in a minute how to clean your utensils so you don't get wax down your drain. So, and that handle is really warm. She brought a pot holder. Okay, so now I'm just going to take this and I have my little scraper tool, and I'm just going to kind of slowly pour it. And I'm not even aiming for the tubes. I'm just kind of pouring it over the top. And it is going into the tubes. And filling them up. I can kind of aim for it, but and I'm going to fill a couple of these little boogers.
Does this, when it cools down, does it shrink down?
No.
Or does it stays mm-hmm. where you put it, right? It
stays where you put it. Okay. So I've got that, and you see I've got some that's kind of floating around on the surface. So I'm going to, this is where I'm going to use this little tool to kind of slide it into the rest of these. And you can see it's starting to set up.
Happens pretty quick.
It does, but not way down low. That's just the top where it's getting the surface.
Sherry K wanted to know, are these available for purchase on your website?
No. No. I have links to them from Amazon. Are you talking about the finished products? Honestly, it'd probably cost more to ship them to you than it'd be worth. But the inks, the links to the ingredients, if you type lip balm, you'll get Amazon links.
Hi, Glenda.
And some of this is going to kind of solidify. And what I can do is I can scrape it off and melt it back down. And then I'm just kind of pushing this along so that I get a nice flat top on my tubes. Now I have a couple of them that I didn't fill because it didn't look like I was going to have enough. So I didn't really want a half a tube. But if I did have a half a tube and I didn't want to leave it that way, I could twist it out put it back in my container and melt it down.
Now, Alana says you make it look easy, which means you're pretty good at this. Is that true, or is it just that easy?
It's easy. It's easy. Okay. So let me give that a few seconds. Okay, so these are the little pots. And I might have wanted to put a little more coconut oil if I'm going to put them in here where I'm going to use my finger, but I think it will be okay. And then I'm remelting this so I can fill up a couple of these. And so I've got a little bit more. Let me see if I can fill that one up. And again, I'm just using this to kind of scrape off, to push it around, and to give me a flat top. Now, somebody asked if it does kind of settle. Sometimes it will kind of put a little divot in the top, which is okay. That's just a function of how fast it cools. So there we go. I'm gonna stop fiddling with it, and I'm just gonna let them sit until they solidify, and then I will put the caps on. I'm taking the cap. I can't remember if the caps come off of it or whether you have to pull the caps off. But I just plop the caps on, put on the labels, and voila, good to go. So this is one I did. My fingers are all waxy and oily. Okay. This is one I did several years ago. And this is what, still in great condition. Goes on smooth. One thing I have noticed is if they're cold, like if you leave it out in your car, which don't leave these out in your car in the summertime. But if you left them out in the car in the wintertime and they got really, really cold, then it's really hard to get onto your lips. But you just kind of need to let it skin temperature melt. Okay, so cleaning.
Brown Eyed Girl Crafting said, I have got to watch the replay. I go through a chapstick.
Yes.
Now, I will say that this is one, I don't use a whole lot of chapstick, but this is one I actually use. Mm-hmm. So I think this... It's not overly done.
And that lipstick gave it just a pretty little color. I don't want to tip it up. Gave it just a pretty color, which I do not, I can't guarantee. I do not believe it will stain your lips. I don't think there's enough of it in there. But just using that Dollar Tree lipstick gave it a little bit of color, which you might not want if it's going to be a gift for a man. Now, you don't want to wash off the wax and the oils in your sink. So take some paper towels and clean off as much of that wax as you can. I mean, a little bit is going to be okay. A little bit will wash away with really hot water. But you want to get as much of that wax off before it goes anywhere near your pipes. Okay. So again, just do paper towels and then clean up with soap and water. Make sense? Does that make sense? There was something else I was going to say. No, I can't remember. Okay, so very easy. Oh, price. I did a little cost analysis based on the prices that I was seeing on Amazon. Now, of course, it's kind of an investment to buy all of these supplies. And if you can buy them in smaller quantities at a craft store, by all means, that might be. But if you want to do this over and over, like I used very little of this. This is a pound, and I used 2.5 ounces. But I did a cost analysis, and it costs, including the tube, about 40 cents each, which is a really good price. You could sell this at a craft fair because it's handcrafted. clock. You could sell that easily for $2 to $3. So for 40 cents, it makes a very affordable gift. If you have an office full of people who you need to or want to give gifts to for Valentine's Day or Christmas, or if you're in a business where you want to have something to offer your customers, a little freebie, this would make a very affordable little item. Okay, so I've just got this wiped out. It's not completely clean, but I've got the wax out of it, so it's not going to damage my, it's not going to damage my drains. Not going to adhere to my pipes. Okay. So, okay, yes, finished product. I would consider selling it, Sherry, but again, the shipping, because it's not flat, it's probably going to cost like $3 for shipping. So unless you wanted to buy a bunch of them, it probably wouldn't be worth it. But hit me up. Let me know if you're interested, and we can see what we can work out. Because I got 50 of them here. Okay, I think, how are we doing on time? I have a few minutes. I think I have time. Do I have time for a quick chalk? Okay, let me show you this cute thing I thought of using this for. I found these at Dollar Tree. These are called Faber boxes, and they're flat. I believe I found them either by the wedding, in the wedding section or the party section. They're just flat boxes that you can't, not even boxes, they're like little gift bags. And I saw these, and I wanted to put together, using our Valentine minis, I'm just going to do this really quick, if I just have a couple minutes. What does the label say? Oh, the label, here. You can tell her what the label says, what our label says.
Well, this one says Ring Cross Farm South.
That was when we were in Southern California.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to chalk on paper. So I'm going to take some surface wax real quick. Don't need that much. You probably just rub my fingers on it because I've got wax on my fingers. So I'm putting a little bit of wax on this so my stencil doesn't stick.
Hey,
and I'm going to use, what am I going to do? I'm going to do the Be Mine. Okay. So I'm going to fuzz this real quick. I'm going to put a little bit of lint on the sticky so it doesn't pull up the paper. I'm going to center it here. These are perfect size for these mini transfers. I'm going to grab, let's see. I'm going to grab my raspberry sorbet paste. I'm going to use a squeegee. And I'm going to squeegee over this with that chalk paste. This is chalk and paste form. Take off the excess. Peel off my stencil and voila, I've got a little decorated, I've got a decorated little bag. Put this down here. Got a decorated little bag. I can push it on the fold lines. I'm going to be careful not to fudge that. Okay, how do I customize labels for me? I think Bill's typing, but as far as a template in this kit, there is an instruction sheet, and it gives you all the information, a downloadable template, and then you just have to create your design. But that might be something that Mr. Bill can help you with, because he's kind of an expert at that. And I'm going to fold this up real quick. I've got 1 minute left. Racing. I can't remember who's on next, but it's somebody wonderful. And put that down.
Okay.
So we're gone. Make yourself some lip balm and put it in a little gift bag and give it away as a gift. So thanks for watching. I hope you follow our page, and we will see you later. Bye-bye.